So a couple months ago when we thought about doing this interview, the idea was that maybe there was going to be a trade deal, and I would have been interested in your comments about how to incorporate that into the outlook, but there is none now, at least not yet. How do you think about that? How does the trade dispute or trade war as it's going on factor into your outlook?
Well, I would say over the course of the last year, trade uncertainty has been a major theme. And we see it in the decline in business investment. We see it on exports, and we see it in the manufacturing sector. So trade uncertainty has been a major factor weighing on the economy for the past year.
Did you factor in the idea that perhaps there would be some easing of trade this year and that tariffs would not go up?
So it's certainly the case that as I've thought about my outlook, prominent among the downside risks to that outlook has been trade conflict. And we've taken out some insurance against that, but we still hear from our business contacts that they're sitting on the sideline waiting for some of this uncertainty to be resolved. I don't think the expectation is for a major deal, but even a truce would be a significant reduction in uncertainty for a lot of businesses around the country that are sitting on the sidelines in terms of investment.
And how would it change your outlook if there were additional tariffs in December?
Well, certainly that would be a negative factor. That would be a realization of some of that downside risk that we've been seeing. But some of the research that we see suggests that just uncertainty alone can be a factor reducing business confidence and reducing business investment. We think we've seen that in the data.
Definitely in your prior life and to some extent in your existing life or prior life at the Treasury, you were deeply involved in international economies and international economic relations. How much does the trade war bear responsibility for the global economic weakness, or is that a separate phenomenon?
Yeah, so I think it's hard to pull those apart. They are completely intertwined for China, of course. China already had some big imbalances in domestic credit that it was working through, and trade conflict has greatly exacerbated the challenges that they're facing. But if you look at the euro area, there Brexit has been a factor, but there are other factors that are also affecting the euro area outlook. And Japan, too, has been certainly affected by trade conflict in the region, but there are some internal factors that are also weighing on their growth prospects.
If you put it all together, the New York Fed's nowcast, the Atlanta Fed's GDP now, they're both at 0.4% for the current quarter. Is that where you are in terms of thinking about the economic growth right now?
Yeah, so that's quite a bit lower than a lot of the consensus forecasts that are out there. I mean, I think we did have some strength in the first half. We expected a somewhat of a moderation. We're seeing that in the second half. But just don't forget, the U.S. consumer has proven enormously resilient. If you look at retail sales, if you look at consumer sentiment, the U.S. consumer continues to feel good about the job market, and the job market continues to be strong. Most of the businesses that we talk to that are consumer-facing continue to be quite upbeat.